In 2016, we took apart everything from the iPhone 7 to the now recalled Note 7. After every teardown, we assigned the phones a repairability score based on a number of factors, including ease of disassembly, the types of fasteners on the inside, and the complexity involved in replacing major components. Here's how some of the year's most notable phones did on our teardown table. Coming in with a repairability score of 8 out of 10, the LG G5 was the most repairable phone we took apart this year. The LG G5 was one of the few phones we saw this year that still had a user-replaceable battery, but it also favored standard Phillips screws and used no adhesive, making it one easy phone to repair. But the Google Pixel XL and the iPhone 7 line were right on LG's tail, all earning 7 out of 10. The iPhone 7 and 7 Plus both had a battery that is fairly straightforward to access, and with the addition of the solid-state home button, a common point of failure was eliminated, making it more durable. The Google Pixel XL had an opening procedure much like iPhones of old. The Pixel XL score was thanks to its use of modular, easy-to-replace components, the inclusion of a battery removal tab, and using only standard T5 Torx screws. The iPhone SE, Apple's affordable-ish alternative, didn't do too badly either, grabbing a mid-pack 6 out of 10. Part of that score is due to the similarities to the 5S, so repairs on the SE are already excellently documented. In addition, the SE's display can be removed first and the battery is fairly easy to access. Samsung's flagship phones, on the other hand, tanked this year. The Note 7 only mustered a 4, though exploding batteries forced Samsung to recall the phones before they had a chance to break. At the rear of the pack, the Samsung Galaxy S7 and S7 Edge. They were the least repairable phones we took apart in 2016. This is mostly due to the display glass. Replacing the glass without destroying the display is nearly impossible. In years past, Galaxy phones have been very modular, so it's a little sad for us to see Samsung go down the path of glued together phones. Of course, thousands of models of phones were released this year, and we can't take them all apart, so it's likely some very repairable and very not repairable phones deserve a mention on this list. If you know of one, be sure to let us know in the comments, and you can check out all of our other teardowns at ifixit.com/teardowns. And if you can't wait to see all of the teardowns that make it to our table in 2017, be sure to subscribe to our channel now. Don't forget to give us a like on Facebook at facebook.com/ifixit and follow us on Twitter @ifixit.